Well, first of all, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Sean. That's Ben. Okay?
But more importantly,
yes.
Jewel.
Jewel. The brand new addition to the Sing Off, which is at season 4 right now. And it's going to be a great, it's the best season thus far.
And yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, exactly. So there you have it. That's all you need to know. Watch it.
I'm a fan of the show, and watching season 3, these guys set such a high bar. You know, they're really honest and they have a lot of integrity musically, and they actually know what they're talking about and what they're listening to. And a cappella music, people don't always know what they're hearing. It's so hard to grasp, but these people are making all these sounds with just their voices. There's a guy playing bass line, there's guys doing percussion. It's an amazing thing to be able to do. They're doing guitar parts, they're doing synth parts, all with their voices. And these guys have so much ability to be able to convey that and help the audience understand what they're listening to. I learned so much watching season 3 and the prior seasons. So I knew that my job, you know, they set the bar high and I'd have to come in on my game. But really, just to have fun. I think we have a great time. We joke around a lot. It's a really fun environment where we're not trying to put anybody down. We're trying to give these people the respect that they're due, which is they're in the position we've been in our lives and continue to find ourselves in. We're trying to figure out how to make a living doing something we love.
We're happy to have Jewel a part of it because she fits the whole dynamic of the show and what it means and the integrity of it. Jewel is obviously an incredible artist and still selling records and selling out tickets today. And that's what's cool about having her a part of the show. She's a viable element, and that's what makes this the experience that much better, not just for us, but for the contestants and the audience as well that'll be watching the show.
I love about these guys, they got into the music for the same reason I did, because we like music. I don't think any of us got into it thinking we're gonna be giant stars or we wanted huge dressing rooms or big buses. I didn't have a diva plan in my mind, and I don't think any of these guys did. We did because we actually just loved the craft, and then the craft, following the craft, ended up making us stars and celebrities and making us a great living. And that's why these kids do the show. None of these kids have gotten to a cappella music to try and be the next Britney Spears. They did it because they loved the craft, and then the craft led them here. So I think we just feel like we have a lot in common.
Yep.
There has to be some trust. They know that we're on their side. If it's something that could be construed as a negative comment, they have to know that. And that's kind of our job. And when you do something, especially a television performance, that's a 2.5 minute thing normally. Probably feels like about 2 seconds. And I'll bet you if you ask them, they couldn't tell you what the hell happened. So we're sort of there like something happened, and they're looking to us like, what was it that happened? And we kind of go, well, here's what happened. Right. You did this and this and this, and this could have been better, but this was amazing. And if they relax to it, which they generally do, I feel like they can certainly improve it. It's teaching me a lot.
Yeah. And I love that we're watching an art form define itself. We're watching a genre create itself. You know, a cappella music it's an ancient form of music. You know, people didn't have instruments and they're making sounds with their voices, from doo-wop to barbershop to choral. And now they're redefining it into what it means now for youth culture and making it relevant again. And I don't know any other genre in music that's actually redefining itself. And so for me, that's what's been really fun.
I think it's a constant outpouring of amazing talent every year. There's so much of it. That's what you learn about where you live. It's like when you watch a show, you can't imagine. There are colleges and there's 18 guys that can sing that well. Like if you're going to college, look around. There's people that are that talented, and they might be science teachers one day, or they might go into the insurance business. But being expressive through your voice and singing and being talented is not as rare as we'd like to think. You know, we do it for a living, and that's very lucky for us. But there are many amateurs that are better than the professionals. Professional just shows up and does it on schedule. Like the reason we're professionals is because someone says, hey, Sean, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, get up and do it. He can do it. You know, the amateurs aren't asked to do that. But God, some of these singers, man, I mean, I do a lot of production recording of singers, and I've recorded a lot of a cappella groups. College a cappella groups will get their vocal tracks down on the first and second take. Mm-hmm. Professionals, try 30, 40, you know?
Yeah, it's true. This is one of the last few pure art forms left. And it's something that, surprisingly, a lot of kids get into and a lot of kids love to do. Unbeknownst to, I guess you could say, popular culture or the powers that be who look for certain things to make a quick dollar. This is something that, it might take a little more elbow grease to get the things to get it out there, but it's still one of the most beautiful art forms ever, and people love it. This is a prime example, and I'm happy that there's a show like this that exists, and I'm a part of it with such great people, and on camera and behind the camera. This is a labor of love for everybody.